When the Babatunde Rajaphasala's administration took off in May of 2007, it could be argued that only few people believed it could take the state through phenomenal transformation such as it has done. Indeed, the administration within the period of its existence has implemented various policies and programs designed to sustain the state's status as a center of excellence. Apart from the fact that this transformation cuts across all sectors of the state, the administration, for emphasis, has made its impact felt in the different senatorial districts, particularly Lagos West Senatorial District. Since inception, the administration has made construction and reconstruction of roads a priority. To this end, a number of roads in the senatorial district were completed. These include Sule Abore Street, Rokpo Owolabi Street, Celestial Street, Adeboye Sholanke Street, Bale Street and Oremeta Street in Ikeja. The dualization of College Road Ogba is seriously ongoing as construction work advances. In Ifakwa Ijaye, Sani Balogun Street, Beckley Estate Phase 1, Man City Olaniyi Road Phase 1, Odushola Avenue, Clem Road, Awolumate and Oguntade Streets, Zawiyat Crescent, Access Roads, Okunsoya Network of Roads, Ajoke Shodamole Street, and Mustafa Olusegun Street were completed and commissioned. In the last 100 days, Governor Babatunde Rajaphasala's administration also handed over the 650-meter-long Market Street Phase 2 in Badagry local government area.
Towards happy motoring, improved economic development and prosperity, I unveil this plaque to commemorate the handing over of 16 rehabilitated roads in Mushi local government area of Lagos today, the 10th day of December 2013. May all those who use those roads continue to prosper.
We build infrastructure that will allow 40 million people to live successfully in Lagos State. So when we build the roads, we think of sustaining it for 15, 20 years. That's why the minimum asphalt in Lagos now is 50 for inner roads and 100 for major roads. And then, of course, there is the base course and the rest. So, but the essence is that we know that the number of people that lives in Lagos will keep increasing, whether we like it or not. People will come and live here. And therefore, we must build infrastructure that can sustain the population that we expect to rise to 40 million in 20, 25 years' time.
There is medical road. There's also a link between the Bankantoni. If you are coming from Bankantoni into Obafemi Awolowo, you know Obafemi Awolowo is also dual carriage, double lane, down to Alausa. So if you are coming from Bankantoni into Obafemi Awolowo, there's a kind of constriction. So there's always traffic bottleneck. But with the opening up, it's now being expanded into dual carriage, double lane. So traffic will flow from Bakadu into Obafemi Awolowo, and then the bypass Adebola Oduyemi into Adegemuto Road. So it's going to ease everything. And of course, you know the Computer Village is there, an international market. So there's no doubt that it's going to improve the economy of the local government and all the stakeholders.
So far, so good. What the government is doing is it's okay, to my own understanding, it's part of development. From my own best of knowledge, I feel this will enable customers to have easy access to the market. I think it's a good thing. I support it. Yeah, the benefit we stand to gain is that it will increase the sales of the market. It will help people to come easily, and people will no longer complain of traffic or the rest of them. I think based on that, we stand to gain from it. It's going to be a very big benefit to we, the business people in this place. If I flash back before the coming of Fashola's regime, Lagos is nothing to write home about. But thank God for bringing Fashola to Lagos State. He has really done wonders in Lagos State. So many. In fact, Lagos is a different city to what it used to be.
In the education sector, their determination to ensure conducive learning environment led to the construction and rehabilitation of 105 classrooms and 108 toilet cubicles across the senatorial district. Among the schools that benefited from this are Ishefun Community Primary School, Alimosho, Agiringwi Primary School, Ikeja, St. Paul's Anglican Primary School, Igborusun, Badagry, Moses Orimolade Primary School in Orile Agege, Alaworo Nursery and Primary School, and Abulegba Primary School, constructed by the Committee of the Wives of Lagos State Officials, CALSO, and commissioned by the First Lady of Lagos State, Her Excellency, Dame Abimbola Fashola.
This is a humanitarian service. It's a service that we should give to our children. We want our children to study in a conducive place. We want our children to be that leader that will be able to think well. When they are in this classroom, they would be able to realize their own dreams and lives.
This six classroom block was built and donated by the Committee of Wives of Lagos State Officials, also with the support of MCM Nigeria and Dangote Group, commissioned today, Thursday, 12 December 2013. Glory of God.
With adoption of preventive medical care as the guiding principle of the state's healthcare service delivery, the administration, as part of its 10-point agenda, has upgraded some existing infrastructure, while new ones were provided in the senatorial districts. This includes Lagos State School of Nursing Complex, Igodo, the General Hospital in Igodo, construction of Maternal and Child Health Complex in Amuodofin and Alimosho General Hospitals, respectively. The administration of Babatunde Rajifashola also supplied and installed neonatal equipment at these centers. Welfare of members of staff was not neglected, as staff quarters at Badagry General Hospitals were renovated. The mortuary at the Badagry General Hospital is also being reconstructed. As part of the drive to further develop primary health care, the administration rehabilitated and commissioned Onigbongbo Primary Health Care Center. Within the last 100 days, over 10,000 people in Badagry benefited from the Equal Free Health Mission.
This is one way of giving the people the dividends of democracy. And we agree with you that health is wealth. It's one of the major important factors that can make man pursue and pursue his vision or dream. So for this reason, we want to enjoin people to continue to pray for the government of Lagos State and government at the local level for them to be able to do more. There are more to come. This is just the beginning. And our people, it is not meant for the animal, it's meant for the human being. And the people will enjoy it. But one thing I want to also appeal to our people is that they should constantly visit their PHCs for medical updates. And in doing this, they can also, we also want to enjoin them to pay their taxes, because these are some of the things we gather together to do all these things we are doing. All these things you are seeing here are free.
People leave the PhDs. There are 277, at least 277 PhDs in Lagos State, and there are about 36 secondary tertiary facilities. So it is easier for them to go to the PhD. It is closer, it is better in terms of relations, because it's in the locality.
Since the independent power plant IPP for Iju Water Works was commissioned, the determination to ensure steady power supply for critical infrastructure and organizations providing essential services is being pursued with vigor. In the course of the last 100 days, Governor Babatunde Rajifashola's administration handed over another 10.6 megawatts IPP power plant, which plant has started supplying uninterrupted power to the Lagos State Government Secretariat and its environs.
This is what is possible as a subnational government. Create our own power. And we've done so from Ikorodu, 270 megawatts, to Akute, to Lagos Island, now to Alausa. As you have heard, This project decommissions automatically 120 generators at the last count. And as the MC has told us, they are not I better pass my neighbor. Some of the smallest there are 30 kVA generators, some go. And Mrs. Ogunbi has told us the aggregate of that power is actually 30 megawatts of inefficient power, lost time, lost accountability, diesel supply, transport costs, downtime, and all of that from today will now be history. But if you want to dimension the size of how big those generators are, they are actually big enough to fill 3 plots of land without leaving any space. That's what we are getting rid of. So here we are, but this is not our destination.
The construction of the Magistrate Court Complex at Ikeja is still ongoing. This edifice is a mark of the present administration's commitment to restore magistracy to its pride of place. As the first level of justice, the Magistrate Court is the closest to the people, and the new building will help in no small way to provide the needed ambience to facilitate the administration of justice. For a senatorial district that has a number of rural areas, various initiatives were implemented to make life more meaningful for rural dwellers. This includes the provision of infrastructure such as the micro water scheme at Ijegun Olong Shogo. The project has the capacity to produce 45,000 liters of water per run with a capacity of 3 runs per day.
A very good thing, actually. We thank the governor for what he has done for us. This one will elevate the suffering of our people, especially in question of water, because we've been suffering of water for a long time. Despite that, the lagoon is surrounding us, actually, it's not drinkable.
Water has to be treated. It's not every water that's potable. People don't know. Water can come out, can look clean, can look clear, but at the same time can be infested and layered with germs and other microorganisms that you cannot even see. You see, you have to treat water. Water is not just coming out and drink water. What most people do? They don't even filter. Even though you filter, how many times do you change your filter? How many times do you treat your water? In my own house now, I have a water treatment plant. I don't know when last I've replaced my filter. So this thing, and there are experts here who are water engineers who know the language of water, who speak the language of water. And they are the people giving us this water. It's a different ballgame entirely.
The rural electrification project at Igbankọ community in Olonda LCDA covers 5.2 kilometers and comprises 1,500 kVA, 33/0.415 kV transformer substation, a 4-way feeder pillar, and 123 span high tension network. With the construction of electric tower at Ibo D Orufo, a riverside community in Ojo local government, the administration has connected many communities to the national grid.
Since 2011, the governor resolved that anytime he's procuring transformer or allocating transformer, we want to make sure that the installation of that particular transformer is equally accomplished. So we are not just handing over this particular transformer. As soon as the handing over is over, the SVD will start to lift these transformers to various locations as identified by the members of the Lagos State House of Assembly. And as soon as that is completed, the rural department of the ministry will start the installations of all these transformers that is being handed over today.
The governor of Rivers State, Mr. Babatunde Raji Fashola, SDM, we hand over 140 units of transformers, out of which 132 will go to the members of the Lagos State House of Assembly. Today, the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, and the Holy
Spirit.
Amen. We
were given order for 140 pieces of transformers by the Minister of Rural Electrification. And the transformer consists of 115 pieces of 33/11 500 kVA, 24 pieces of 500 kVA, 33/415, and one number 200 kVA, 11/415 kV. The transformers are the one you are looking at. We have stacked them. They are 140 pieces. They are, you know, labeled and customized according to the requirement of the ministry. We put the name there, the user, the end user.
In the course of the last 100 days, the dilapidated wooden footbridge used to access Ese Ofin in Otto Awori LCDA for several years was replaced with a 240-meter concrete footbridge built across a marshy land area. The project now facilitates exchange of goods and services between the community and the outside world.
So the security of lives and property is not just putting guns and men on the street. It is also about thinking of policy initiatives that help further protect lives, reduce accidents and the consequential losses. The first security strategy of this state and any serious state is to keep the economy going and keep it going. And we have dealt with that. As the executive secretary has told us, criminals are like those rows of trees in the cafeteria. Once you pick up one, there's always another tree. But once we have a larger populace of the economy at work, in school, in one productive undertaking of the other, our capacity to focus on those difficult trades will not change, increases. But in 7 years, again, as the chairman has told us, we have developed a security apparatus that has improved upon what we inherited.
In addition, 4,020 people were trained and recruited as neighborhood watchers. This comprised 1,369 regular watchers and 2,651 volunteers. These people are well kitted and provided with necessary equipment needed to effectively carry out their duties.
The issue of succession of His Excellency Governor Babatunde Raji Fashola, SAN, in Lagos State, which necessitated its being an integral part of the 10-point agenda of this administration. Since his assumption of office in 2007, has been doing his best to improve the security situation in the state by equipping the RRS and the police command in the state with the state-of-the-art cadets to improve their performance in combating crime. The state government, realizing that it cannot do it alone, also set up the Security Trust Fund to generate more support to fight crime in the state. It has also been supporting and equipping the neighborhood watch in order to be more active in the monitoring of their communities. However, for close to 6 years now, no training has been organized for our watchers, and this has greatly affected their performance, more so since a lot of those earlier trained by ASA Training Academy in 2006 have left the service. This has resulted in the majority of the watchers we have now not being well trained. This therefore underscores the need for this training design to put the round pegs in the round hole. How to be more efficient in security surveillance. Not satisfied with this, we decided to go a step further by organizing this training program, where the watchers will be taken through practical and all-round security training so as to empower and make them more effective and efficient on the job.
In order to empower the women and men alike, the Ministry of Women Affairs and Poverty Alleviation carried out a four-week training for 300 retiring officers in different skills and vocations. The training, which was held at the Women Development Center in Agege between September and October of 2013, was designed to empower the retirees and give them the skill they can live on after their disengagement from active service. As the major tourism site of the state, Babatunde Rajafashola's administration is reinforcing this position for Senatorial District in Badagry with various restoration and rehabilitation projects ongoing. As a result, the former colonial district officer's residence, Vlekete Slave Market, Heritage Museum and the Badagry Marina and Shoreline Protection Project are at various stages of completion. 2,400 days down the line, the administration of Governor Babatunde Rajafashola has not wavered in its commitment to transform the state, especially Lagos West Senatorial District. With much already down and more to do, it is expected that the current efforts would be sustained, thereby taking the state up the ladder of development.